Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure to welcome all of you to the Ping An Tower Room. My colleague Chen Zhang and I will share with you the application and management of BIM in Ping An Finance Center. Considering the fact that I'm going to deliver this presentation in Mandarin, and the fact that there were quite a few words in my slides, so definitely I require interpretation.
这两天的论坛会议，在这个厅里面呢，大家也全方位地展示了一个600米的超高层，在这么一个超大、复杂的工程项目上面，在设计、技术、施工、管理以及理念上面的等方面的挑战和实践。
So we have heard a lot about the super scale of this project, the Ping An Tower, that is more than 600 meters tall, and the difficulties and challenges that different people face during construction and management, etc.
CCDI 也是从2008年的10月起，我们有幸加入了那个平安项目团队的一员和优秀的境外的建筑师、专业顾问、强大的业主以及我们强大的总包方一起共同服务至今。
CCDI luckily became a member of the Ping An project team in October 2008. We consider it a great opportunity to have the chance to work with world-renowned architect firms, owner, as well as contractors.
作为一个国内设计院，CCDI提供的是施工图的出图的这个工作任务，这是内容一。那其次，我们是为期5个月的施工图出图的时间。第二个服务是从2009年的11月份提供到现在提供的是现场的技术服务。那第三个内容是从2012年的9月份，我们提供了 BIM 咨询的顾问服务。那在这个过程之中，我们从二维的设计到出图，以及三维的辅助设计，到最后的 BIM 的就是信息化。
So in the first during the first stage of the project, the CCDI as a domestic vendor was responsible for supplying drawings for a 5-month period, and starting from November 2009, we provided on-site technical support, and starting from September 2012, we're responsible for supplying beam-related services, whether it's 2D drawings or 3D drawings.
我会接着讲我们在 beam 应用的第一部分内容，就是我们应用的出发点。那这个时候就是说我刚才前面也讲过了，作为一个国内院，我们承担着这么重要的，就是一个600米的超高层高度带来的技术的挑战和压力。那这个时候就是说，为了我们提高工作效率。 然后保证那个阶段性的成果的交付，最终让业主的满意。在这一方面的话，我们为了达成以上的这样几个目的，我们必须要去寻找，就是说借鉴比较前沿的或者先进的设计工具和工作方法，来完成这样的一个任务。这个是也是我们进行自我实现的一个原动力。
So talking about the reasons that we decided to use a BIM application, well, first of all, we are talking about a project that is super big in size, over 600 meters tall. We will face a lot of technological challenges and pressures in order to make sure that we can improve efficiency, in order to make sure that the project is going to be completed on time and the client is, and the owner is going to be satisfied, we decided to use BIM, which is a great tool or methodology.
经过五年的这个实践，我们现在阶段性的进行了一些回顾和总结。在应用的出发点上面，我们总结为四点：第一是复杂高难度项目的整体的管控；第二点是空间利用与布局；第3点是辅助项目的技术的管控；第4点是多专业的协调配合。
So over the last 5 years or so, we have learned a lot. We have gained a lot of great experiences, and that can be characterized as the following 4 points with regards to BIM application. First of all, the overall control of a complex and challenging project. Secondly, space utilization and layout. Thirdly, assist project technical control. Last but not least, the coordination amongst professionals from multidisciplinary backgrounds.
这个我们和其他的大多数的BIM应用技术的起源一样。
So talking about the real motivator at the beginning, before we start to consider using BIM, really there are 2 points. First of all, as mentioned earlier, space utilization and layout. And secondly, to further facilitate the coordination of professionals from different discipline area background.
这个就是因为正是当时我们在2015年的4月15号全面接收了尽管公司顾问的初步设计成果以外，我们在准备施工图出图的一个条件制作的期间，然后因为形体的复杂，然后包括进高要求的这个技术协调的难度非常的大，在这样的情况下面，我们加大了对于三维辅助设计的应用。我们用了前后用了8个星期的时间，对于整个大楼所有的顾问进行检视，也可以这么说，就是平安三里的进高要求也是现在现场团队所有的团队压力非常大的一点。在前面的4个星期里面， 我们选择了两个样板层，就是12层，就是第一个最大的4000平米那个左右的标准层，以及和25层的那个设备机电层来进行所就是三维的辅助设计。在这个4个星期里面，就是我们解决了我们CCDI 内部各个专业之间的协作的一些流程，也包括工作方法。 最后的4个星期，我们又检视了其他的17个特殊楼层的部位。我们最后的成果是8个星期之后，这栋楼直接由588米涨到了598米，也就是现在平安的体量。So
after the handover of the assignment from the foreign company to our to the hands of ours, we have been assigned with this, we are responsible for coming up with the 3D drawing for the entire building. We spend in a total of 8 weeks in order to come up with 3D drawings for the entire building, and that is the reason. And you all know that the height clearance requirement from Ping An is 3 meters, and that is partly explains the reason why our on-site staff members are under such big pressure. So we spent the first 4 weeks studying in a very detailed manner. First of all, the standard story covering an area of 400 square meters, and then the 25th story for M and E installation. So after that, we have done a lot of internal digestion, and we were able to further optimize the process and our methodology, and that we spent the remaining 4 weeks time handling a total of 17 special floors. And after 8 weeks time, the previous 588 meters height has been adjusted to 598 meters.
这一阶段的应用对于我们设计方来说，那就是保证了尽管公司比较优秀的设计理念全部落地，也能按时保证出图，满足工那个工地整体的工期的要求。那在这种情况下面 ，CCDI 除了拥有一个独立的结构计算模型以外，我们还有一个基本完整的三维信息模型。
So the reason that why we are able to finish to complete our assignment fulfill our assignment in such a timely manner is, on one hand, CCDI has this independent structure processing module, and on top of that, we have this 3D information system.
这个阶段对于业主的空间来讲，就是通过了可以直观的三维实体模型，以及可以模拟的施工以及进度的虚拟，另外一个就是可以量化的工程造价。其实那个时候应该更多的是工程量，这一点的话是让业主便于决策，敢于决策。
So with this 3D model that we have displayed and presented to the owner, they enjoy benefits such as a clearer view about the construction process, a clearer understanding of the schedule, and a better understanding of the measurable cost factors. And this has motivated them to be able to make better decisions.
也正是基于这样子的一个成果，在2010年的12月底，平安有再一次把 BIM 的应用纳入了那个启动的那个历程。在这一个阶段，就是我们有反反复复，因为对于我们来说 ，CCDI 也有这样子提供 BIM 服务的一个优势，但是我们用了两年的时间和平安反复来确认应用点和需求。So
with that in mind, PN Group has announced by the end of December 2010 that PN is back on the radar, and CCDI has spent a total of 2 years' time working very closely with our owner in identifying the requirements points.
在这里面，我有三点想在这里面提出来。第一个是因为平安是保险金融行业的。 对于风险的控制以及投资回报这方面的控制是非常排序比较高的。那正是因为这样子，就是说每一笔的投入必须有一个比较实际的交付物或者是有一个数字的反馈。那这上面就是我们如果一开始提出来的很多的应用的一些尝试，在和平安的一些协商过程之中，有一些就放弃了，这是一点。 第二点的话呢，是从2010年到2012年的这3年左右的发展， 在国内的 BIM 应该是说是日新月异。我们通过就是整个行业，也包括我们自己，在这3年里面，我们的工作重点就是对 BIM 的认识，从模型转到了信息。就是 BIM 的话，它可以装载或者是扩充的信息会越来越多，而不仅仅是。 三维的实体模型，这些内容。第三个的话就是我特别要提的，就是非常感谢平安，对于 BIM 的这个应用以及行业发展的这个支持，即便是在还没有完全确定需求的这个情况下面，也采纳了我们给他的一个建议，就是在土建总包里面增加了，以及后续还没有进行招标的这个工程。 类的这个文件里面都加了对于 BIM 的应用的需求，以及要服从 BIM 资讯管理这样的一个大纲，也让我们就是后期的 BIM 的这个资讯管理的实践得到了考验。So
I would say that there are three points that I would like to share with you. First of all, Ping An as a time-honored company in insurance industry. Attaches great emphasis on risk control, and from Ping An's standpoint, they want to make sure that every cost that they have, every amount of money that have invested, they expect to see delivery or in the format of debtor feedback. And second point I would like to share with you is that BIM has witnessed a very rapid development in the Chinese market in the last 3 years from 2010 to 2012, in these 3 year period. And from our company standpoint, from the entire industry standpoint, we do have the same impression that BIM has enjoyed very rapid development. And last but not least, I would like to say thank you, Ping An, for your great support for the BIM application, even when your requirements have not been finalized with us yet. And so, and on top of that, you have also taken the suggestion from us by adding BIM-related clauses into your key documents, which is a very which is very motivating from our standpoint.
也正是由于我上述的一个介绍，我们在和平安反复确认的过程之中，以及包括我们现场的总包，我们一起共同在 BIM 的应用点上面，我们有最初的12条比较理想状态下的，然后缩减到了目前的这个7条。这7条的内容基本上是在我们现场实际上是可以操作，然后具体在应用的这些点。
So by working very closely, as mentioned earlier, by working very closely with Ping An, as well as the main contractor, we have the previous 12 application areas of BIM have been further trimmed or streamlined to 7.
接近五六十人的这个团队，是通过这种三维可视以及三维辅助这种设计来进行工作的。这个就是当时我们发的是机制的成果，可以说我现在可以把它，还是看着比较简陋、比较原始，就是1.0版本的。那个时候对于建筑子系统专业之间的拆分，我们做的还不是十分的精准。
And so, you know, the previous slide shows you how we have carried out the work during this 8-week period. Our team of 50 and 60 have worked very closely to make this a 3D drawing a reality. I wouldn't say this is the best one yet. I would just call it 1.0 version.
这个是由我们的幕墙深化设计，承包商提供的幕墙的这样的一部分信息模型。那可以看得到，打个比方说，我们在2010年的时候，是为1.0版本的话，那这个可能它也像前进步了一点，我们就是1.5版本的。这一个的话呢，是施工现场的一些布置的模拟，这个都是属于总包他们来进行的一个BIM的应用和展示。这也是属于我们的钢结构的那个生化以及承包商，他提供的一个模型，在这一部分的话，可能就是说，是属于那种可矢量化以及参数化表现更优异的一些软件，需要和我们的基础的模型的软件有一个装载。
So the slide before shows you the curtain wall simulation. The curtain wall was supplied by a contractor of ours. And I would say that the 2010 version, if we call the 2010 version 1.0, then we can call the current version 1.5. And the second image I just showed you in the previous slide is about the simulation of the construction site. And the third one is regarding this steel structure, and it requires loading from other relevant systems.
这也是属于我们的普建大总包，就是进行的施工进度的一个模拟。
And this is the scheduled simulation.
这是在施工工艺的模拟，比如说爬坡和塔吊的爬升，这也是属于总包单位提供的。这是在现场利用模型进行的进度的管理的一个展示。This
is a snapshot of one of our management meetings where you can see how they use the BIM system for project management purposes.
可以说就是说，我刚才通过陈述以及展示的话呢，如实的反映了平安在现场，以及和甲方就是对于BIM的应用的一个实际状况。在这一方面的话，也得到众多的参与方的支持，无论是作为幕墙、生化单位，还是说是总包、普建总包、机电总包以及将来的室内，他们也都会采用这样的方法和那个工具。在这一块的话，我们目前 CCDI 是承担的咨询管理的顾问的一个职责。到2016年竣工的时候，我们会向甲方最后整合定交竣工模型。 可以这么说，就是在 BIM 的这个应用上面，可以借用我们刚才王总说的一句话，就是建立你的团队，管理你的团队。那在我们这个 BIM 的模型，就是 BIM 的应用上面，我们是建立模型，也要管理模型。那我们是如何实现这个管理的？我想交给我们那个同事秦江来阐述。
And so, just to quickly, I'll walk you through how we have applied BIM for this project and the great support we have received from not just our own, not just from Ping An, but also from MNE contractors, from construction contractors, and they all have made this pledge to continue to use BIM as a great tool. And from our standpoint, we see the role played by CCDI as a consulting company. We see ourselves as a consulting for this project. And by 2016, when the entire building is going to be completed, we are going to submit the complete set of models to Ping An. And I would like to quote what Mr. Huang said earlier when he said, Dr. Huang, when he said, build a team and then manage your team. I would say that on a similar note, we should first of all build your model and then manage your model. And next up, I'd like to invite my colleague Chen Jiang to share with you more details.
在平安这样一个超级复杂又是非常多的，我们介绍到100多个分包商左右。那BIM 的应用，大家前面看到，其实上不只是一个技术，而且要保证这种技术的实现，我们意识到整个的管理过程也是非常重要的。
So I'm sure you've heard a lot about the complexity of the PM project already, with more than 100 subcontractors working on the same project, and the application of BIM on this project is not just a technological challenge, but also a management challenge.
在和平安业主2年多的磨合里面，我们一起来制定了关于平安项目、关于 BIM 应用的一系列的基本原则。那么第一个原则呢，就是要求的合同对应的一致原则。那么这个要求，BIM的工作范围与二倍条件下的合同工作范围要求要一致。那第二个就是呢，我们是要求在合约里约定的各个参与方的BIM工作要求。
And over the last two years, working very closely with Ping An, we have agreed to the following basic principles. Principle number one, contract consistency. The scope of work defined should be consistent all across. And then by contract BIM requirements.
第二个基本原则呢，我们要求实施过程的同步原则。那这里面在设计过程之中呢，我们要求的是模型的统筹之后才能发布图纸。这个设计不只是我们 CDI 的施工图，也包括在现场后期的深化设计。那同时呢，在施工过程之中呢，我们要求模型有一个及时的更新，能让模型能确实应用到大家的实际工作中。
And principle number two, implementation in parallel. During the design stage, the integrated BIM model should be from the integrated BIM model to drawings. And during the construction stage, the BIM model should be updated in a timely fashion.
第三个原则呢，我们要求的管理职责的一致性的原则。那么 BIM 管理职责的分配应该与项目合同的架构和管理职责相一致，这样来确保每家的参与方能在自己的这个同样的管理职责内来工作。
And principle number three, consistency in terms of management responsibilities. So the BIM management requirements shall be consistent with the requirements defined in the project contract.
那在 BIM 的管理实践中呢，我们主要做了四件事情。第一个是约束 BIM 参与方的责权利。
So these are the four areas that we have worked on with regards to BIM management.
这个表是我们在上面用到的这个平台金融中心并不参与方的职责分工表，是针对每一项应用的，针对每一个参与方的。
First area of responsibilities and rights provided in BIM contract, and this table here is entitled PAFC BIM participatory responsibilities. So basically, it defines the responsibilities of.
第二项呢是我们要建立一个完善的管理体系。那么这个图片呢是平安金融中心BIM的组织架构图，实际上在其每个参与方的内部也有他自己的一个完善的组织架构。那这个我们作为BIM顾问是要参与到其中的。
So the second area that we have worked on is the establishment of a complete and well-defined management system. This will show you the org chart. So actually, similar org charts would be there for different participating companies.
那第三项呢，是我们做了一个非常重要的工作，就是优化模型的操作流程。那么在这个流程里面，是要求因为我们的模型是在各个参与方之间来回的流转的，要不停的加工的。那么这里面细致的我不细说了。这里面重要的就是一个是关联与区别，另外一个是模型操作管理上，另外是模型操作流程的适用性与合理性，在这三点你要给予充分的重视。
So the third area we have worked on is the optimization or model operation process. Just to highlight the three most important points here. First of all, the relationship and differences between model operation and BIM applications. Secondly, model operation management. Thirdly, rationality and application, applicability.
那最后呢，我们是要求BIM应用成果。效果要能满足现场实际需要，那么这里面包括了BIM实时导则的编制，也包括了BIM应用实体成果的一个互检。照片是我们用移动设备用于BIM模型检查现场。
And the last area, the fourth area we have worked on is making sure that the results from BIM application are going to meet the requirements from on-site staff members. And so two points here, really, the preparation of BIM guidelines and cross-check of the models and buildings. And so these snapshots here show you how we have taken advantage of models and devices such as tablet to conduct BIM management.
特别说一句，平安现场现在基本可以实现无纸化办公，大家都是打开代码到现场去解决实际的问题。
I think it's worth mentioning that basically we have achieved a paperless process for the entire on-site management at PN Group. So all of us are going to work upon the same platform by visiting different mobile devices, whether it's the mobile phone or tablet.
最后是四点结论。一个是组织管理是 BIM 技术获得应用成效的一个必要保证。第二呢 ，BIM 在项目中组织管理形式应该与项目总体的组织管理形式保持一致。第三，通过合同等方式保证各参与方在项目中运用 BIM 技术的效果。第四，项目应该有自身完整可行的 BIM 实施导则。
So these are the four key takeaways as the concluding part of my presentation. First and foremost, organization management is the key to success.In BIM applications, and secondly, BIM organization management shall be in accordance with the project management, and thirdly, to make sure that all participating parties are going to make sure that all participating parties are going to implement and apply BIM technologies in the contract.And last but not least, make sure that there is a complete and feasible BIM guideline for the project.